Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Priya. I'm back with another video for you guys. I just arrived from Chennai today in the morning. This month has been pretty busy for me because I've been flying so much. Show you clips on what I did in Chennai. And to be very honest, I had breakfast and then I slept straight 15-16 hours. I woke up the next morning, like which is today in the morning, around 3-4 o'clock, and then I headed straight back to Abu Dhabi, which means basically I didn't do anything in my Chennai layover and sleeping. Sometimes our body as cabin crew gets so tired that some layovers just pass and you don't come to know. Watch me what I did in Chennai, which is basically nothing, and then come right back and we'll talk. I'm in Chennai and first things first, I have to show you the room. The reason why I love India layovers, hotel rooms. Oh my god guys. Hotel rooms, this is my washroom. That's my suitcase, trolley bag, and that's my room. And look at this couch. It was 4 hours flight from Abu Dhabi. It was a night flight, so obviously I haven't slept. I love South Indian food, so I'm going to order myself some nice food and just go off to sleep for like 2-3 hours, wake up, maybe go to the gym if I feel like, that is. So I'm just about to now take a shower and order some food. I don't know if I should order food first and then take a shower, or should I take a shower and then order food. I don't know, I'm just like confused as usual. I avoid eating on flights because if you ask any flight attendant, they will tell you that they try to avoid as much as possible to eat on flights, only because it's not very healthy and the food is frozen food. It's not like fresh cooked food. So we try as much to avoid eating aircraft food. So yeah, I haven't eaten on the flight a bit. I just had tea. I'm so hungry, so I need to order food now. Done with shower. I have a friend who's come to visit me. Just in case you're wondering who it is, look at this. Oh, you see this? Oh my god. What the hell? I don't know. I have something that I usually put in case if you are interested to know what I put. The pore minimizer. Apparently it should get rid of this. Shit, I hope it goes away. So my breakfast is here. I had ordered for rava dosa. That is coconut water, sambar. So yummy. So that was my epic fail for my Chennai layover. Video is basically a Q&A video because a lot of you guys have been kind enough to comment on my videos and ask me questions also on my Instagram. So I just decided to video just sitting at home and answering all of your questions. Thank you so much for all the questions that you've asked me. In case if you're watching my video for the first time, welcome. My vlogs are all about travel, beauty, skincare, about questions on relating to cabin crew. So if you have any questions or if you like my video in general, just subscribe to my channel and I hope I will entertain you guys. Without further ado, let's get started. So I shall answer all of your questions. Okay, question number one was from a girl called Sonam. She is from Tibet. Hi Sonam, I really hope to visit your country one day. And here's your question. Can I join international airline without domestic airline experience? Good news, not only for you Sonam, but for everyone out there. Yes, you can join international airlines without the experience of domestic airlines. However, it's an added advantage, especially as Indians. It gives us quite an exposure. Me coming from the part of India that I'm from, it was quite difficult for me. I would have never known how to join international airlines or Etihad if I would not be flying back in India. For me, it was a boost. It was a very good experience for me to know the basics of how aviation is. If I really like flying, because So many people I know join aviation and they quit within 6 months to 1 year because flying is not their thing. They realize that maybe they are having health issues or they just don't like work in general, or they kind of don't get used to the lifestyle of a cabin crew for going back to their desk job or to their studies. So for me, the best thing was to join the domestic carrier and to realize that yes, it is my thing. It is something for me. I can grow myself in this career, which is why I continued staying in domestic airlines for a while. And then as soon as I turned 21, I applied for international. Having said that, you don't need to have domestic experience in order to apply for international. I hope I've answered your question. Of course, we've been chatting on Instagram after after that, so we'll stay in touch and I'll definitely help you with more information if you need so. The next question is from Riddhi. Okay, how's life in the UAE? Speaking, it's been 5 years that I'm staying in the UAE. Definitely one of the most safest countries, especially for women, to live in. I can go out at night, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 1 o'clock, with that assurance that nothing is going to happen to me. That does not mean that I will take my safety for granted. Every country has its good side and bad side. We as girls need to be careful no matter which country we are living in. General, UAE is a very safe country to live in. It is very peaceful. Dubai is like an hour away from Abu Dhabi. So let's say if I have days off, for 4 or 5 days I tend to head to Dubai to meet some of my friends or just to chill out and hang out. But in general, I prefer Abu Dhabi because it's more quiet and more homely, and I love my apartment. And yeah, so living in the UAE is quite nice, except for the weather, because it gets so hot and so humid. Like 10 months of the year is just hot and humid. Maybe the November, December time is like the months where you can just like go out in the evenings or during the daytime. The weather is pleasant, it's not cold, but the rest part of the year, so hot and humid. I feel sorry for all the laborers and all the workers who work day and night outside to build houses and apartments in the sun. We also have a labor law which is in place that a worker, the laborers should not be working from midday, which is from 12 to 2 in the afternoon, because of chances of getting sunstroke and stuff. So yeah, we have labor law in place. However, the weather is pretty bad. Apart from the weather, living in the UAE is pretty nice. We have a lot of malls here, some of my favorite places where I go to eat. My best friend is also my flatmate. That's all about my life in the UAE. Next question. Please make an accommodation video. This question is from Devesh. Devesh, first of all, thank you so much. You've been regularly commenting about your request for an accommodation video in all of my vlogs. My next vlog is going to be the accommodation video. Next question is, what is your height? From Ahana. Ahana, thank you for the question. My height, I'm 5'4", which is about 165 centimeters. If you're asking me this question regarding the height that is required to apply for a cabin crew job, in the interview is they will make you stand and ask you to reach your arm just to see if you can touch 212 centimeters, which is the height of the overhead bins that we need to reach, you know, because in the aircrafts we'll have to close the overhead bins after the passengers have all settled down. So if you can reach that centimeters without your heels, if you can touch that, you are good to go. As per my knowledge, you have to be a minimum of 5'2", but depends. If your arms are long, like mine, like see, my arms are like, it's long. So if your arms are long, to be honest, I'm pretty short. 5'4" is not tall, so it is short. So yeah, but my arms reach. They reach, yeah. So if you can touch 212 centimeters during interviews, you are good to go. So the next question is, what's your favorite country or city? Okay, honestly speaking, it's a very tricky question. Now most of you might be thinking, oh, she's traveling everywhere around the world and she must be having some favorite destination in the world. If you ask me this question when I turn 60, probably I'll have an answer, because now I'm actually in love with all the places I've traveled, all the countries that I've been to. I don't have an answer because I love every country, every place that I've been to. I've left a part of my heart in that place and I've had good memories in that place. Even if it's good, bad, it's my own experience. So I cherish them for now. I do not have a favorite country or a destination. Yes, I'm still traveling, I'm still discovering new places. So I'm on the process of still finding out which is my favorite city in the world. And when I'll be in my 70s or 80s, if I'm alive that time, and if you guys are still watching me on YouTube, I can probably answer that question. What languages do you speak? Okay, I speak English, of course. Then I speak Hindi, which is the national language in India. A little bit of Bengali. Just here and there, I mean, just for the purpose of understanding, but it's not very fluent, so don't judge. And I also speak Oriya, which is my mom's mother tongue. Also, I'm not very fluent, but I can still manage. Are you a senior crew? This question is from Wissam. Yes, Wissam, you're right. I'm a senior cabin crew member. In our company, we have different designations. Like, let's say the junior most position is called FA, which is flight attendant. Then on top of that, we have the business class crew, which is FJ. Then we have first class crew. Then we have food and beverage managers. We have in-flight chef. And then we have the cabin senior, who is second in charge of the bigger aircrafts. And when it comes to small body aircrafts, let's say 320, which is the small narrow body aircrafts which flies to closer destinations which are close by, the cabin senior is the only person responsible for that aircraft. On a bigger plane, we have someone above a cabin senior, which is called cabin manager. One person cannot manage the whole aircraft by itself, so it's kind of divided. Overall in charge is the cabin manager on a bigger plane, and the cabin senior is the deputy. And when it comes to a smaller aircraft, then the cabin senior is in charge of the entire plane. So yes, I am a cabin senior. When is the next interview date for Etihad ground staff? Okay, this question is from Sameer. Sameer, if you really want to find out when do we have interview dates happening for Etihad ground staff, I am not the website. There is a website, as I mentioned in my previous videos. You need to go to Etihad Careers. You need to register yourselves. You will see the open dates for interviews for cabin crew or ground staff or any other job that's happening, because I'm not an HR here sitting who's going to tell you guys that when is the interview dates happening. Upcoming cabin crew openings coming up, they will be on Facebook. They'll be actually everywhere. They'll be on Facebook, they'll be on Instagram. People will be we have also Etihad Airways pages on Facebook and Instagram, which invites people to come and attend their interviews. So yeah, I'm not the best person to ask if there is any interview going on, because honestly speaking, it's all on the website. Ground staff is a very huge term. In ground staff, you have so many categories. There are people working in the baggage belt area. There are people working at the check-in desk. There are people working at the ramp. So there is a wide definition. If you're asking me a question like, you know, when do you have the dates for ground staff? You're not specifying to me like, what is your position or what role are you applying for? So the best thing I would say is just you go on the Etihad's career page and check out the dates and the criteria for yourself. And yeah, I can assist you with other stuff, but with the dates, I'm not too sure. Do you spend money on every layover given by the company, or do you spend your own money? Okay, it's a very nice question. Thank you, Richa, for this question. So yes, the money that I spend on the layover is my own money. End of every month, we get paid our basic salary and we get paid for our layovers. So layover allowance is the allowance, the time you spend away from your base, which is Abu Dhabi. The hotel is provided by the company. The food that we eat is our own charge. We need to pay it by ourselves. End of the month, when we get our salary, we get our basic salary. And apart from that, we also get our layover allowances, which is this hotel allowance. We pay ourselves on every layover. However, that is kind of paid back to us at the end of the month through our salary. I hope I've answered your question. Next question. Can you make a brow video? I love them. Sudipta. Oh, Sudipta, thank you so much. I really appreciate that you love my brows. But Yeah, it's just a trick that you need to know when you draw your brows. But yes, I will make a video for you very soon. If I could answer some of your questions. Thank you so much for commenting. It makes me feel very happy because it's my day off today. I'm just sitting at home. Today I'm flying tomorrow night. Whenever I'm at home, I'm just lighting up some candles, sitting in the couch, having some green tea and just relaxing by myself. I really love staying at home. I'm not a party person. I do not like going to parties when I have days off. I like to just sit at home, chill, watch Netflix and relax. If you have any suggestions for me, any comments, please do keep writing to me. I love reading your comments. And thank you so much again. Thank you for supporting me. I hope to see you in my next video very soon. And take care of yourself. This is Priya wishing all of you a very good night and lots of love. Bye now.